Hello, my dear students. Today I will discuss about few more questions and answers. The topic name is Categories of Computers and Computer Languages, Part 2. The next slide contains few more questions and answers. Question number E. Answer the following questions. Number 1. How are microcomputers different from mini computers? Answer. The differences between microcomputer and mini computers are as follows. Microcomputer. Number 1. Microcomputer was introduced in 1970, but mini computer was introduced in 1960. Number 2. Microcomputer generally consists of one processor, but mini computer generally consists of two or more processors. Number 3. Microcomputer's storage capacity is in GB, but mini computer's storage capacity is in TB. Number 4. Microcomputer's memory is in MB, but mini computer's memory is in GB. Microcomputer is a single user, but mini computer is a multi user. Number 6. Microcomputer's size is very small, but mini computer size is bigger than microcomputer. The next slide contains next part of questions and answers. Question number 2. Describe mainframe and supercomputers. Answer. The characteristics of mainframe computer are as follows. Number 1. Mainframe computers are more powerful and are also more expensive than microcomputer or mini computer. Number 2. They can support multi-users and to handle large amount of inputs, outputs and storage. Number 3. They have huge memory capacity. Number 4. They are used in banks and government offices. Example, IBM 370, 3000 series and UNIFAC 1180 are the examples of mainframe computers. The characteristics of supercomputers are as follows. Number 1. They have greatest processing speed and they are extremely powerful computers. Number 2. More than thousands users can be supported by supercomputers handling large amount of data. Number 3. They are used in space, meteorological application and weather forecasting. They are used as e-commerce servers. Example, Crayon, Param are the examples of supercomputers. The next slide contains the next part of questions and answers. Question number 3. Mention two advantages and two disadvantages of machine level, assembly level and high level languages. Answer. The two advantages of machine level language are as follows. Number 1. Programs written in machine language do not require any translation for the computer to understand. Number 2. The response time of machine level programs are very fast. The two disadvantages of machine level language are as follows. Number 1. It is difficult to write programs in machine level language because they consist of two digits only. That two digits are 0 and 1. Number 2, it is machine dependent as it directly refers to the memory location. The next slide contains the next part of questions and answers. The two advantages of assembly level language are as follows. Number 1, assembly language programs use special symbols instead of 0 and 1 called mnemonics. They can perform operations such as add, sum, etc. Number 2, it is easier to write program in assembly language in comparison of machine language. The two disadvantages of assembly level language are as follows. Number 1, assembly languages are also machine dependent language. Number 2, assembler converts assembly language programs into machine language. The next slide contains the next part of questions and answers. The two advantages of high-level languages are as follows. Number 1, they are closer to English language. They are very simple in nature and are easy to write program. They can work with different types of operating systems. The two disadvantages of high-level languages are as follows. Number 1, they need language translator to convert high-level language into machine-level language. Number 2, the response time of high-level language program is less. Students, in this session, I have discussed about some questions and answers. That's all for now. Thank you.